Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so our lesson today is for basic concepts in daily interest. Okay, so this concept we will use to convert day into years. Okay, so dengan kata lain, konsep ni kita akan gunakan untuk mengira T. Okay, so tukar daripada hari kepada tahun. Okay, kalau sebelum ni, kalau bulan, so number of months divide by total months in a year. Okay, so dia ada atas dengan bawah. Okay, so this one numerator lah, yang atas. Okay, so to calculate the number of day. Okay, so between two dates, so we have two concept, which is exact time and approximate time. So what is exact time? So exact time is exact number of days between two given dates. Okay, so meaning that if January 31, so we use 31 days. February 28, so 28 days. March 31 days. April, so April 30 days. 31 days. Okay, so two meaning exact number of days between two given dates. Okay, so kita gunakan jumlah hari yang betul-betul lah dalam tiap-tiap bulan tu. Okay, okay, so for approximate time, okay, so untuk approximate time, we assume each month has 30 days in the calculation of number of days between two given dates. Okay, so setiap bulan kita akan assume sebanyak 30 hari. Okay, so tak kira Januari, Februari, March, April ataupun Mei, so kita akan gunakan 30 hari sebulan. Okay, so that one is approximate time. Okay, okay, so yang exact time tu, siapa yang tak ingat? Susah nak ingat, nak pakai tombol-tombol kat jari tu. Okay, so saya tak boleh lah nak tunjuk kat sini. Okay, so tombol kat jari tu, yang benjol-benjol tu 31 hari dan yang lekuk tu 30 hari dan 28 hari. Okay, okay, so next, so this one for the interest. Okay, bukan interest ni, so denominator dia, so untuk pembawah dia, so divide by, okay, so bahagi dengan berapa hari. Okay, so that one depend on exact simple interest or ordinary simple interest. Okay, so if exact simple interest, so we use 365 or 366 days in a year. Okay, so setahun kita pakai 365 ataupun 366 hari. Okay, okay, so kenapa ada 366 dan 365? So this one is for tahun lompat. Okay, so tahun lompat 366 sebab Februari ada 29 hari. Okay, so ordinary simple interest, okay, so we use 360 days in a year. Okay, and another one you need to know about the banker's rule. So banker's rule, we use exact time and 360 days a year. Okay, so nanti kita tengok. Ni four basic concept. Okay, so dia akan gambar exact time and exact simple interest, or exact time and ordinary simple interest, and then approximate time with exact simple interest and approximate time and ordinary simple interest. Okay, so first kita tengok exact time and exact simple interest. Okay, so exact time and exact simple interest, so T we calculate as number of days calculated using exact time. So exact time, tadi exact time apa? Tiap-tiap bulan kita gunakan hari yang tepat lah, jumlah hari yang tepat, 30, 31 ataupun 28. And then divide by 365 or 366. We use exact simple interest. So exact simple interest tadi kita pakai 365 or 366. Okay, okay, so yang saya tulis kat sini denominator dan numerator dia. Okay, so next exact time and ordinary simple interest. Okay, So exact time numerator dia sama. Okay, so exact time numerator sama macam yang atas, but ordinary simple interest denominator here already change to 360. Okay, so next approximate time and exact simple interest. Okay, so approximate time numerator number of days we calculate using approximate time, tiap-tiap bulan 30 hari. And then exact simple interest denominator dia 365 or 366. And last one approximate time and ordinary simple interest. So approximate time numerator we calculate using approximate time, and then denominator is 360. Okay, so banker's rule which one? So banker's rule using exact time and 360 days. So yang ni lah. So this one is banker's rule. Okay, kita tengok contoh nak lagi faham. Okay, so find exact time and approximate time from 16 March 2019 to 26 July 2019. Okay, so from March until July, so we has March, April, May, June and July. Okay, so kita ada 5 bulan, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, March is 15 day. For the exact time, approximate time is 14. Okay, so macam dapat 15. Okay, so March total of day we have 31. Okay, 31 days per month. Okay, so kita ada 31 hari dalam sebulan. Okay, so this one for March. Okay, so from 16 March until 31 March. Okay, so 16 March until 31st March, the number, total number of days is 15. Okay, so kita gunakan 31 minus by 16. Okay, so we have 15. Okay, so for this one, approximate time 14. Okay, so 14 since each month for approximate time, since we use 30 days for each month, so therefore 14 we calculate by using 30 minus by 16. Okay, so 30 tolak 16 dapat 14. Okay, so next April, May and June. So April full month, May full month and June also full month. So therefore April is 30, May is 31 and June is 30. Okay. Okay, so for the approximate time, okay, so all the same, 30, 30 and 30, 30, 30, 30. Okay, so for July, so July until 26 July. Okay, so from the 1st of July until 26 July, so we have 26 day. Okay, so for approximate time also same, 26 day. Okay, so biasanya yang hujung ni kita ambil terus sahaja 26. Okay, so yang awal ni yang kita tolak, okay. So kenapa? Okay, so March. March kita ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30 and 31. Okay, so ni tarikh-tarikh dalam bulan March. Okay, so dia nak from 16 March until 31 March. Okay, so maksudnya kita tak nak yang belakang ni. Okay, so this one calculate one day. Okay, so two days. Okay, so maksudnya kita akan kira start daripada sini ya. So sehari, dua hari, 3 hari, 4 hari dan seterusnya. Okay, so daripada sini, so maksudnya yang belakang ni kita tak nak. Okay, so here we need to remove. Okay, so that's why 31 minus by 16. Okay, so kita buang yang 16 hari ke belakang tu. Okay, okay, so yang ujung ni 26, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so sampailah 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 dan 26. Okay, so yang ni memang kita nak ambil yang depan ni. So tak payahlah kita nak tolak. Nah, so just kita ambil terus 26. Okay. Okay. So total number of day dia from 16 March until 26 July is, for the exact time is 136. Okay, so tambahkan semua 15 plus 30 plus 31 plus 30 plus 26. So we have 132. Okay, so for approximate time 14 plus 30 plus 30 plus 30 plus 26, which is 130. Okay. Okay, so this one we will use to calculate interest. Okay, so example here, RM1000 was invested on 16 March 2019, and if the simple interest rate offer was 10% per annum, so find the interest received on 26 July. Okay, so here I will show you. Okay, so saya akan tunjukkan cara how to calculate interest by using four concept. Okay, so saya akan tunjukkan empat-empat konsep lah. Okay. So, tapi nanti dalam soalan dia kadang minta satu ni je, satu yang pertama ke yang ketiga ke. Okay. So dia akan bagi tahu nanti. Okay. Okay, so from 16 March 2019 until 26 July 2019, so we already calculate here, total number of days is 132 for exact time and 130 for approximate time. Okay. Okay, so interest rate is, here is 0.1. 1000 is principal. Okay. So first concept number one, exact time and exact simple interest. So exact time meaning that 132. Exact simple interest, so we divide by 365. Okay. So jangan ambil 366 sebab 2019 tahun 4. Okay. So macam mana nak tahu? Ha. So 2019 divide by 4, 5 20 0 0 so 1 0 okay so 0, and then 19, 4 times by 4 which is 16. Okay, so nampak kita ada baki, so balance. So ada balance ni maksud dia bukan tahun lompat. So kalau tak ada balance, meaning that it is loop year. Okay. So kalau tak ada balance, dia akan jadi tahun lompat. Okay, so ada balance, dia bukan tahun lompat. Okay. So 365. Okay, so by using I equal to PRT, because find the interest. So we have here 1000 times 0.1 and times by this T. So we have 36 ringgit and 16 sen. Second, exact time and ordinary simple interest. So exact time we use 132, and then ordinary simple interest is 360. Okay. So nak ingat senang je lah. So O dan 0 belakang dia. So ordinary 360. Okay. Okay, so I equal to PRT. So we have 36 ringgit and 67 sen. Okay, so next, approximate time and exact simple interest. Okay, so approximate time 130, so 130, and then exact simple interest 365. Okay, so we have 35 ringgit and 62. Okay, next, approximate time and ordinary simple interest. So approximate time, so we use 130. Ordinary simple interest, so we use 306. Okay, so we have interest equal to 36 and 11 sen. Okay. Okay, so just now banker's rule is exact time. Okay, so banker's rule, exact time and ordinary simple interest. Okay, so kenapa dia pakai yang tu, exact time and ordinary simple interest? So kita bandingkan, nampak dia yang lagi banyak, interest dia lagi banyak. So this one, banker's rule dia akan gunakan lah, sebab dia nak dapat untung yang lagi banyak. Okay. So siapa yang tak nak dapat untung lagi banyak kan? So that's why banker's rule use number to exact time and ordinary simple interest. Okay, so next, ini soalan sebenar dia lah. Okay, so a loan or bukan or ni, so a loan of, okay, so this one of, a loan of 3,000 was made on 20 March 2019 at a simple interest rate of 6% per annum. Okay, so a loan of 3,000, so this one is P. Okay, interest rate 6%, so R is equal to 0.06. Find the accumulated amount on 14 June 2019. Use the banker's rule. Okay, so banker's rule just now is exact time and ordinary simple interest. Okay, so therefore we need to calculate the exact time from 20 March until 14 June. Okay, okay, so draw table months. Okay, so number of days. Okay, so months start from March and then April, May and June. Okay, so sampai June. Okay, so March, from 20 March until end of March. Okay, so daripada 20 March sampai hujung bulan March. Okay, so March we have 31 day. Okay, so we have 31 minus 20, which is equal to 11. And then April full month 30, May full month 31, and then June until 14 June. So we have 14 day. Okay, so we total, so berapa total? 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. And then 3, 3, 6, 7, 8. So 86 days. Okay, so next, calculate T. So T is equal to 86 divided by ordinary simple interest, which is 360. Okay. Okay. Okay, so next, the question is ask to find the accumulated amount. Okay, so find the accumulated amount. So this one accumulated amount, so you need to find S. Okay, so substitute into formula of S. S is equal to P, which is 3,000, 1 plus R, which is 0.06, and T is 86 over 360. Okay, so the answer is RM 3043. Okay, okay, so next example. Okay, so on 27 July 2019, Siti put 2,000 in a saving account. So 2,000 in a saving account. Okay, so ni maksudnya dia punya modal lah, principal P, that offer a simple interest rate of 2%. So meaning that R is equal to 0.0. Okay, so find the amount in her account. So find the amount, so meaning that we need to find S. Okay, so cari jumlah dalam account dia. So jumlah dalam account maksudnya dia punya modal tambahkan lagi dengan interest dia lah. Okay, so find the amount in her account on 1 November 2019. Okay, so first we need to find P. Okay, so draw table. Okay, so days. Okay, so first we have July and then August and then September. After September, October and then November. Okay, okay, so dia sampai November and then here to. Okay, so number of days, July, 27 July and end of July. Okay, so July we have berapa hari? August 31, June 30. So July is 31. Yeah? So 31, 27 July until 31st July. Okay. So 31 minus 27, which is equal to 4 days. Okay. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, 31. Okay. So August 31. Okay, so sebelum tu, okay, banker's rule. So we use exact time and ordinary simple interest. Okay, so exact time, ni kita kira ni exact time. Ordinary simple interest 360 divide by 360. Okay, so next September we have 30. October 31. And then November 30. No. Okay, so November until 1 November. Okay, so only 1 day. Okay, so total number of days 1 plus 1 plus 1 3. 3 plus 4 is 7. Okay, so 3 plus 3 plus 3 is 9. Okay, so 97 days. Okay, so next find S. So we already have T. Okay, so T is equal to 97 divided by 360. Okay, so find S. S is equal to P, which is 2000 times 1 plus R is 0.02 times by T, which is 97 over 360. Okay, so the answer is equal to RM 2010 ringgit and 78 sen. Okay. Next, another example. Last. Okay, so another example. On 10 March 2019, Kalmah deposited RM 800 into a saving account. Okay, so deposited RM 800. Okay, so dimasukkan duit, dia deposit RM 800. So meaning that this one is modal dia lah, principal dia. Into a savings account which pays 4.8% simple interest rate per annum. Okay, so this one is R. So R is equal to 0.048. Okay. 8 month later, she withdraw RM 200 from the account. So find the amount left in the account after the withdrawal. Okay. So 8 month later, kita so dia keluarkan sebanyak 200. So keluarkan minus lah, minus 200. Okay. Okay, so T sekarang ni berapa T dia? R kita ada, so T. So tak ada pun dia bagi tahu exact time ke apa benda, banker's rule ke. Ha, memang tak ada. Okay. So sebab dia dah bagi 8 month. So meaning that 8, T is equal to 8 divided by 12. Okay. So 8 bahagikan dengan 12, which is equal to 2/3. Okay. Okay, so next to find jumlah duit yang tinggal dalam account dia. Okay. So we need to find first S. Okay. So jumlah dia selepas 8 bulan berapa banyak jumlah dia. So mula-mula dia deposit 800. And then dia dibayar interest banyak 4.8%. Okay, so selama 8 bulan sudah, so berapa banyak duit dia beranak. Okay, so lepas tu dia keluarkan sebanyak 200. So nanti kita kena tolak 200. So first we need to find S lah. So S is equal to P, which is 800. Okay, so in bracket 1 plus RT. So R 0.048, T is 2/3. Okay, so we have here berapa. Okay, so after 8 years, money already become RM 825 ringgit and 60 sen. And then she withdraw RM 200. Okay, so therefore balance baki dia is equal to 825 ringgit and 60 sen minus by 200. So which is equal to RM 625 ringgit and 60 sen. Okay, so habis. So finish. Okay, so finish for today. Okay. So thank you. Okay, so jangan lupa buat latihan apa semua. Tak faham boleh tanya, okay? Okay, so that's all for this time. Okay, so thank you. Assalamualaikum. Jumpa lagi nanti.